more about the situation with Russia is Congressman Mike Quigley. Thank you so much for joining us, Congressman.
Thank you. Good evening.
Good evening. Do you think that the end goal for Putin right now is to reassemble the Soviet Union?
You know, I think that's what's in his dreams. I think that's what ultimately this is all about. He sees Ukraine as part of Russia from a historical point of view, in a twisted way, almost in the same way we see one of our states as part of the United States. And I think that's what this is all about. It's not whether or not Ukraine as a sovereign nation should have the ability to join NATO. And because he knows Ukraine's not going to invade Russia. This is an age-old belief by Putin and others that Ukraine is part of their country.
Obviously, this is what you are working toward right now, but do you think the United States is going to be able to tamp this down? And will the sanctions that have been discussed be strong enough to do the job?
You know, that's the question. And if history indicates this, it has to be a multilateral effort. Right now, my biggest concern is that Western European countries recognize this isn't a threat to Ukraine. This is a threat to not just Eastern Europe. This is a threat to all of Europe, and they need to be involved and on the same page with all of our allies. We have to be on the same page talking about crippling sanctions, not just against the oligarchs or sanctions that have been implemented over a period of time. And it has to go toward the things that Putin cares about most, you know, his energy sector, removing them from the SWIFT banking system so they simply can't do business with the rest of the world. So the United States is doing its part on the diplomatic side, and we can't give up on sanctions. It's never on diplomacy. It's just never too late to try.
Well, some say that the U.S. is making vague threats. They should be a little more forceful, maybe arming Ukraine.
Well, since 2014, we've given Ukraine, we've allocated $2.5 billion in military aid. That's everything from boats to anti-tank missiles to extraordinary training and a list of many other things. Recently, there's been another $200 million in emergency aid, and I believe we should get the clearances in place to move other U.S. military equipment currently assigned to NATO to Ukraine as quickly as possible. But, you know, let's not forget, Russia is the third largest army in the world. If they invade, this will be something akin to a modern-day blitzkrieg. So it's never too late for diplomacy. We have to make it as difficult as possible for them, and we have to give Ukraine the tools it needs to defend itself.
Well, given the stakes that you just described there, Congressman, and knowing how important all this is, do you think that this could lead to American troops on the ground there in Ukraine?
You know, I certainly don't see that unless circumstances that aren't clear right now were to take place. I don't think Ukraine thinks that's possible. They are not a member of NATO, although I wish they were, and I know they'd like to be. But there's obviously a lot at stake, and we need to do everything else we can to avoid this conflict.
Congressman Mike Quigley, good to talk with you this evening. Thanks so much.
Anytime. Thank you.
All right. Well, a show of strength in the Indian